Hi everyone, Saeed here. Today I'm going to teach you how to design a gorgeous PowerPoint by using some simple rectangles. First, let's check it out. You won't believe how easily you can design this beautiful slide. You can use this template for so many different ideas. For example, you can use it to report the percentage of people who are vaccinated with COVID vaccine. This slide belongs to a pitch deck PowerPoint template that I have designed recently. This template has more than 80 unique slides, and each slide has its own features. It's modern and built to impress your audience, which offers professional designs that are fully customizable. Elevate your next presentation with this stunning template. The download link is in the description. Okay, let's design this gorgeous PowerPoint together. Let's start by drawing a rectangle. Right-click on it and choose Format Shape. In this window, rotate it 20 degrees. Now, hold the Ctrl key down and expand it until its height is bigger than the slide. Let's draw another rectangle. Set its height to 7.5. and width to 5.6. Drag it exactly to this side of the slide. Let's remove its outline and send it back. Now drag this shape over the rectangle. Select this shape first, then this one. Go to Shape Format tab, and then in the Match Shape section, choose Subtract. Hold the Ctrl and Shift keys down and duplicate the shape like this. Change its color and send it to the back. Again, duplicate the new shape, change the color, and send it back. Now select all the shapes and choose Distribute Horizontally from the Align menu. Okay, so far, so good. Select these two shapes, right-click, Format Object, and add a drop shadow in this direction to them. Set the transparency to 80, blur 100, angle 70, and distance to 50. Let's change their color to white. Now select this shape and change its color to white with 50% transparency. Also select the middle shape and increase its transparency to 25%. Draw a rectangle and change its height to 6.25 and width to 12. And align it to the middle and center. Let's fill it with a picture. Choose Picture or Texture Fill and then insert your picture. Let's remove its outline, I forgot it. When you add a new picture, it is distorted, so you have to go to the Picture Format tab, and in the Crop menu, choose Crop to Fill. As you see, distortion is gone. If you want, you can adjust your picture, and then click on the outside. I want to change the picture. Select it, go to Change Picture menu, this device. Don't forget, you have to always choose Crop to Fill when you change your picture. Let's send it back. From Shape menu, draw this shape. Remove its outline, then drag this little yellow dot to adjust the shape. Be careful about the picture border. We don't want to uncover it. Now we have to add a center shadow to the shape. Set its transparency to 0 and blur to 100%. Let's change its color to this white. Okay, it is time to add your text boxes. I am using the Montserrat font family. The download link is in the description. Let me draw a rectangle to separate the title from details. Select these and by pressing Ctrl G, group them. It is time to animate the slide. Select these three shapes and add fly-in animation to them. Change the direction to from left. Increase the duration to 2 seconds and set a start with previews for all of them. Click on this little arrow to open the properties window and drag a smooth end to the end. Now open the animation pane. Select this shape in the middle and set 0.1 seconds delay for it. Again, select the first shape and set 0.2 seconds delay. Let's see a preview. Select the entire group of text boxes and add fade animation to it. Set a start with previews and 1 second duration. Also add 1.25 seconds delay. Okay, let's see how it looks like. Amazing, but we have to add one last animation. If you remember, at first I told you we are going to design this. Did you notice? We have a zoom out for the picture. Let me show you how to do it. Select the picture and add the fade animation to it. It starts with previews. Duration is 1.5 seconds and delay is 0. But for zoom out, we have to add the grow animation. We don't want to zoom in, we want to zoom out. So select the smaller from the effect option. Don't forget to set start with previews for this animation. Okay, here is the tricky part. I want to see this picture exactly this size after zoom out. If you notice, its width is 12. This number is important. We need it later. Let me open the properties window. Right now, the zoom out amount is 50%, but I want it to be 90% of the actual size. So type 90, enter. Drag a smooth end to the end. Okay. Now we have to expand the picture, but how much? Is this good? No. If you want the exact value, you need some mathematical calculations. If you remember, the size of picture after zoom out is 12, which is 90% of the expanded size. That means 90% of x is equal to 12. We can conclude the x value is equal to 13.34. The problem is solved. Select the picture and go to the picture format tab. Click on this arrow to open the format picture window and check the lock aspect ratio. It is time to increase the width to 13.34. Since we have locked the aspect ratio, its height is changed as well. Now we can align it to the middle and center. Your PowerPoint is ready, but let me tell you something. You can redesign your slide by dragging these shapes. Feel free and redesign it to see which slide is your favorite. Alright, let's see the final result. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, don't forget to subscribe and ring the notification bell for additional upcoming videos. Alright, I'll see you next video.